That's like we always do.
That's right. Normal.
All right, then. Relax?
Sure.
Sure.
Music is, it's designed to for joy. That's the whole idea, to bring joy to people's lives.
Music is my root, and the music that the great jazz musicians confess to play here in Canada is my music, just because it's out of my church, just music to God.
When I was a teenager in New York, I didn't really know what I was witnessing, but I stumbled upon the Miles Davis band when it was probably the greatest Miles Davis band ever. It was, in that band was John Coltrane, Cannonball Adderley, Bill Evans, Philly Joe Jones, Paul Chambers, and I went to a couple of concerts, and from that point on I was a convert. If I heard some of my relatives saying something negative about black people, it didn't square with what I was hearing, you know, because I was hearing such fantastic music coming out of black musicians that I knew that I didn't see any white musicians doing that. I had several friends who were conscripted to go to Vietnam and came back in a body bag, and I really didn't believe in the war, so I had the opportunity because I had a sister living in Toronto, and once I got here, there was no looking back.
First of all, it was a beautiful city. That's why we decided to stay. Actually, we came to visit, and then we were called back to work.
Not violent like a lot of places are, and everyone I've met here has something positive to say.
I think I met Jim, to know him was the first time was at the Zanzibar, and then later on I began to play at the Silver Dollar, and it became like a jam. All of the musicians used to come down to Dollar, saxophone players, guitar players, organ players.
When I first met John T, it was amusing. We were both sitting in at the old Zanzibar Tavern when they used to have music during the daytime. And we started playing Old Man River together, and I was impressed with his sense of swing. To me, jazz playing, you have to have that spark of talent, then you have to put in the work. And I knew just by the first 8 bars, when I listened to him play and the way he constructed his bass lines, that he was definitely knew what he was doing and was a dedicated, serious musician.
I'm from Virginia, and Jim's from New York. When we met here, we put on concerts together and played in jazz situations together, gospel situations together, recording together. We have written music together. It's just the spirit of being human beings, recognizing the gift of life even before the gift of music, and brotherly love, which is understanding. I know his talent. He has a great talent. He knows my talent. He knows my intent. And my intent and his intent is to sound the best we can, to sound as good as possible in music. Thank you.
it's harder than what the classical musician can do, because a classical musician in many ways, even though he has accomplished a masterpiece by Bach, he's going to keep playing that masterpiece over and over and over again, and a jazz musician could never come out and play the same solo twice.
I've played places that I don't even remember the name of the place. I don't remember where it was. I just know it was in Canada, but where are you, like you have a family, you have to work. Sometimes the gigs that come along are great, the perfect setting, good money, great audience. Then sometimes you may play somewhere, it might be three people in the place, they hate your music, they be glad when you go, and you be glad when you go,
I remember playing one time for a group of lawyers, and them telling me, well, I make 100 times the money that you make, but I think you have 100 times the fun that I have. There's very few actual outlets for jazz. I mean, George's Spaghetti House is one, but that's always been kind of a small clique of musicians that play that one club. A few places like East 85th will come and go, and they last 6 months or a year.
I find it very, very hard for this music to be recognized here, in Canada, where I have played the same music back in the States. And it's been more recognized. Like here, it's appreciated and it's liked. But that seems to be but as far as it goes. Like, I've been living in Toronto since 70, that's 18 years. I've never been asked by any of the agents or the musicians union, well, John T., such and such person is in town, they need a piano player. Even if I wasn't qualified, which I feel that I am, but even if I wasn't qualified, it seems like I would be one of the people that's asked.
The difference between the white and black musicians is this, basically. If a white player can imitate a good black player, a master, he usually has a place in jazz. I can't say that would be the same for the black players.
A black player has to be really original to make it in the jazz world.
My life gets brighter all the while. No one can match your style. You take